I was gonna do my intro, but I don't think it's necessary.
Go ahead and do it.
I forgot what my intro is.
You idiot.
Hold on. probably gonna edit this part out, guys. Oh, hey, it's DBR back for another video. Stay tuned. We're going to be doing a Get Ready With Me, and I have my good Julie here that does bomb makeup. So if you need her information, all her information will be in the description down below, where you can contact her, where she's located, and all of that. Once you see her do me, you're gonna want her to do you. So just stay tuned, watch, and learn for a few of you, because I've seen your makeup and it ain't great. So just watch and learn. Please learn something, please. Sick of walking past people in the mall and shit's fucked up.
Already primed and moisturized.
So, I'm already primed and moisturized, so we'll be moving on to the next step. Yes. Can you see that? Can you see?
Who knows?
Can you see that, people? Can you see that? Yes. This is the foundation that I'll be using. Is the Revolution Conceal and Define Full Coverage Foundation. You see that? The Bomb Diggity for us brown queens. You gonna use your hand? Oh, you're gonna actually use the stick?
This is only for you.
Sounds so familiar.
Ew, nasty. Keep your head down.
It dries very quickly. You going lower, so I'm going higher.
No, I'll adjust you. I need you to be adjusted. Just for my animals. Just more affection.
No animals were harmed in the filming of this video.
I do like using this company's foundation because it does blend into the skin very, very easily. You can just see how it's so creamy and not heavy and it doesn't overly clog your pores. Beautiful foundation. And when it says full coverage, it truly means full coverage. Brush that over my eyelid. So they blend down the neck so there's no line of demarcation.
Okay.
Next, you can see that. You can
make it out. Okay, next is by Revlon, which is this
Revolution.
You know what I meant. Fast Base Concealer.
C14?
Yeah, C14. Yeah, it's on there. You can see that? In the corner there? Somewhere, let's see, right there. Keep doing it, it'll surprise you. It surprised me.
I did mine this morning too. I use the same thing. I love this stuff. Look up.
Alright.
Alright.
Come together. Very creamy. Blemish free, full coverage, smooth looking.
Oh.
Oh, look at that.
On the side of the camera. Side of your face. There we go. Now we're all blended.
Damn, getting me together. You see what I'm talking about, guys? You see what I'm talking about? Information will be in the description. This is the first time I can actually say all y'all bitches gonna be one that look like me. Alright! I mean, the regular local bitches wanna look like me. The bitches around the world? Yes! That's what I'm talking about. Get into it! Alright.
Alright, look up. I'm just gonna set the under eyes.
Like Sandman, Spider-Man.
So ridiculous.
That's what it reminded me of.
Oh, you haven't even opened this yet.
Not yet. Well, now it is. When I did the look the other day, I did everything but that. I didn't feel like doing all that. It was just for a quick picture. It wasn't supposed to be. To riches story. Before and after. Go from looking like Randall from Monsters Inc. to Carjon. Draw a line completely straight on a piece of paper, but you can draw a line completely straight on someone's face. It's just so weird.
Loose powder is always difficult.
Oh, I probably would have never noticed that either.
Yeah.
Until the end.
Mm-hmm.
I want it set, but I want to just use what was previously on the face. Brush it out over those spaces that don't need to be as mattified as much.
Will be highlighted, so no worries.
Just blend out anything that doesn't want to be there. always on wanted lines. Lightly going over the whole face with some setting powder. If we leave it on for too long, it's gonna look cakey and gross. See way too many lines. I'm trying not to see barely any at all. I'm trying not to break my nail.
No, usually there's a piece of tape. There was a piece of tape on the other one that I did not see.
No, because, oh yeah, you're right.
Yeah, there was a piece of tape. I was about to do that same thing. If I would have broken my nail, it would have been. Yes, the bronzer. I'm bringing out the bronzer. Get my Kim Kardashian on. Thank you. That sounded right. It does. It sounds like an Italian food.
Now this is, if you want to go ahead and introduce that as well.
Alrighty. Okay, so from Revolution, this is the bronzer. This is what it looks like. Okay. And it is the highlighter, reloaded, time to shine bronzer. This can be found at the good beauty stores. Yes.
So I do like to go into this with a wet beauty blender, or a damp beauty blender rather. This way, gives a longer lasting effect and glow, and we can easily blend it out into the skin so there's no harsh lines. Beautiful, beautiful bronzy glow. I just want to put it right over my nose. Keep it bow, a little bit on the chin.
That's what you call that? The Cupid's bow? That's what that's called?
Over the lip? Yeah, that's your Cupid's bow.
Oh, I call it my troublemaker. Because every time it opens, there are parts from my bottom lip. It's trouble starts.
Look up. I'm going to take out all of the powder left over underneath the eye, because you always want that to set without any creases. Okay.
which is a good tip for some of you older folks. I'm not gonna say any names, but I know a few that want to be forever 15, and they should be worried about forever 56, but each his own. Alrighty. Yay, has that cake got a genre yet?
Just want to angle out contours a little bit more just to deepen the cheekbone. And I do hold my brush and kind of open it like a little bit like a fan, so it gets a little bit more angled and precise.
It's going right where you put it.
I'll go right over here.
Okay. Yes, get into it. Get into it.
A little bit of blush. Okay. These are very pigmented. Smile for me. Nice, like,
what brand is that?
This is from Ofra Cosmetics. Okay. This is Ofra Cosmetics blush palette for professionals. And kind of blend it out to the cheekbones so he doesn't have just simply pink cheeks. It look very natural, very nice natural blush. Subtle, not too crazy.
Which is something you won't see me doing very often. Blushing is never my thing.
No, but just to give it a nice little rosy glow. So it's not just all one simple foundation color.
Yep, that's true.
And I will be going over again with the Revelation.
Yeah, exactly.
That's okay. I haven't been able to speak all day. Tried to say Ross earlier and I said Russ.
I can imagine that. I'd be like, what store is that?
This is just for a little more bronzy tone. I'm just gonna go over the whole face with the rest of it. And I will be highlighting after this. So this is just for some natural bronze.
Yes.
And now typically a lot of people like to do the eyes first and then they don't mess up any of the rest of the makeup, but I do them last. I tend to not have very much fallout. I tend to be careful and have very good control of my brushes. So what we will be doing currently,
but again, each his own, so whatever works for you is what works for you. You can follow all the other steps and do your eyes first, that's fine, yeah. Whatever, but
for me, I just like, yeah, for me, I like to do eyes last.
Okay, I do the eyes last.
So what I'm going to do is have you close your eyes. I'm going to lift up eyelid just by holding on to the eyebrow. That way I'm not messing up anything else. And you see I kind of have my hand curved, so I'm not putting my hand straight directly onto his face. Do this and get right into the crease with a nice dark brown. It's not too dark, just so I can go and see where his crease is. And now I'm not going too dark because I don't want the whole eyelid to be dark. And always remember, start off little, then add more, because what you can't do is reverse the situation.
It's too dark, then it's too dark. You have to live with it.
Best to go little by little and just add more if needed. Blending that out so there's no harsh lines.
Ooh, I touched the thing. My bad.
Did we?
Touch this, the stand.
Oh. I didn't even notice. I hope it didn't rock.
It did rock a little bit, that's what I'm saying. Oops. I'm gonna blend right underneath that with a lighter color.
Go over the whole eyelid.
So we are going to be doing the baby smoky eye today.
Again, lifting by the eyebrow, not touching the face. Just going to pat it in real quick. Like I said, you want to start off lighter and then go darker, not go ahead and put a bunch of dark black eyeshadow in there. When you're never sure about anything, always, always be sure to blend. If you think it's not coming out right, just keep blending. Close your eyes. This way and this way. Perfect. This eye's a little bit darker, so I am gonna just touch, and I haven't added any more eyeshadow, I'm just tapping it in. Any leftover that was on the brush from before. Blend that in.
Perfect. Just a little smoky in there now.
Almost there. Almost there. This is where most moms would just stop, you know, and go pick up their kids. But we're going to do the rest of the routine here. But it's perfectly okay to leave it like this.
I will be going. And doing the under eye, you can go ahead and look up for this part. Look at this. You should probably brush underneath the eye and blend it into a little wing, I could say, right up here. The outer corners of the eye. Just blend, blend, blend. Now I only picked up a tiny small amount of eyeshadow, and I'm just blending that all throughout the underlid, but I did start in the outer corner and blending that out. Again, you can always go back and add more, which is what I just did. Adding right here in the outer corner and blending out.
Do you want to keep it more natural right now, or you want to do a little bit glam?
Well, I did want to put a sparkle color on top.
That's what I'm doing right now. But yeah, if you want to keep it,
that's what I was.
All right, I'm gonna do this nice little gold color right here. So, anyways, this is a eyeshadow, the Velvet Rose Reloaded Revolution eyeshadow palette. And I did not say this before, but the crease color. This one right down here, and then underneath where I blended out on top of the lid is this one right here, and then of course for the smoky part I use this little sparkly black color right down here, and right now for the top of the lid for that pop of sparkly glitteriness we're going to use this gold right here.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's really going to go well
with everything else.
Yeah.
So. Alright, so I'm going to close your eyes.
I will be stretching out his lid again by the eyebrow. You can already see amount of shine on this particular eyeshadow. I'm just gonna pack it in there. But I'm not going all the way to the outer corner because we still want to keep that smoky effect.
It's like super quiet in here.
Well, that's kind of good for the viewers, but then they can sit back and think about why they've been giving Kim Kardashian all this attention and not me. Like, Kim who? Just a thought. Hit that subscribe.
Gonna add a little bit more right over here.
Again, not fully going all the way out to the outer corner of the eye, keeping it on the lid in the inner corner.
All right.
Yes, there was a little bit of fallout, but I'm just gonna brush that away very lightly. It's a good thing that we did put bronzer all over the face, so it kind of adds to that bronzy look.
Oh, wait, we need to get on the competition show. We do. I mean, I need to be on a TV show regardless, but... like, have Kelly Clarkson has her Kelly Clarkson show, and I need to have a show like that. I don't know if it would be a talk show, though. But I definitely.
And now for the under inner corner, I'm going to be going in with this lighter.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Glittery color. That way it doesn't, you know, overshadow the top lid. We want to keep that nice and bright and vibrant and glittery and popping. I'm never gonna say that again in my life.
Mm-hmm.
Too old for that.
Like this.
No. Look up. I am going to hold his eye very gently so I'm not rubbing away any makeup. I'm going to pull it out just a little bit to get the inner corner. Just press it in there and then blend it out. Just same thing on the other side. Press it in, press it in, press it in. And then blend out.
Lights.
And I'm going to have you close your eye, and I'm just going to take his inner corner a little bit more, and his outer corner, I should say, and pull that out so I can get his inner corner without getting the brush into his eyes. Press, 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 and blend. All right, you can go ahead and open. And at this point, we will go back and do... some
trying to keep it together because I am that bitch.
Anyway, so we are gonna go back and add more shadowy with the dark black eyeshadow. We're gonna do more in the outer corner because I always wanna, you know, add a little bit and then add more, add more, add more. Have you look up for this one? I only used a little bit, not a lot. Let's see. Beautiful. We will be adding a little bit more. I want a little bit darker in the corners. Got my brush. That's my brush. Hold on a second.
Yeah, I was gonna say,
be press it right into a very, very, very small amount. I'm just going to press it into the outer corner. Outer corner. Press and blend. Blend outwards, not inwards. Blend, blend, blend. Right underneath the brow, skin tone shadow, just to brighten that up.
Yeah, I was gonna say probably like a highlighter or something too.
No, just regular nude, because we don't want to
add too much glitter and shininess to distract from what's already on the lid of the eye. Over here. Like I said, skin tone. Eyeshadow right underneath the brow. Not on the brow, but right underneath. Alright.
And now we will be moving on to the brows.
Alright. To be red carpet, blue carpet, Emmy carpet, ready. What is here? I'm gonna be so big one day, I'm gonna have my own fucking carpet, okay? Thank you. Yes, indeed. Woo! Maybe 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue, maybe? People can dream. That piece of orange chicken you get in the White House, anybody can. Oh, did I say that aloud? Jeez.
I'm just gonna lightly fill into the brows.
Snapchatting me. He is interrupting my glam. Thank you. Me and my glam squad of one.
Excuse my very loud AC. Very cold in my house. I hate Florida. I only live here because my parents live here. Okay, I'm just gonna go right underneath the eyebrow and get a lighter shade of eyeshadow.
Should not be able to do that so freely.
What are you talking about?
If you move my face like that, it means that it's time for a Botox appointment. People who like their forehead stiff.
And I will be blending that out. There's a little harsh. Very, very little. There. And now for highlighter.
Guys, I am trying not to scream. being cosmetologists, this is what gives us life. I don't know if you knew that. Both of us are cosmetologists, so
obviously,
this is what gives us life. Like, I don't know. If you're not happy with what you do, then that's a problem. If you're not excited to get up and go to work every day, knowing that you will be working for the rest of your life, that's a problem. Find something that you love to do. Do it. And be happy doing it, like we are. This is a prime example of what being happy in your profession looks like. We're never bored. It's never a dull moment. But there's always a challenge. Somebody, you know, with a fucked up head of hair comes in, and, you know, you gotta fix it. So, thank you for people who could care less about their appearance, because, you know, lets us do our job to make you feel good about yourself. That's really what cosmetologists do. They make people feel good about themselves. So
the highlighter that we will be using today is the Essence Sunkissed Glow Palette. We are going to go...
Oh, I was going to say, probably going to use a date.
No. We're going to go in with the very first color right now. Very little bit at first. Onto the very, very shiny bronzer that we already previously put on. I'm using very little bit of melt. This does get pretty bright pretty quickly.
That's fine, I don't want these bitches to see me from space. Alrighty. People gonna be hating or whatever, but it's okay, y'all can hate. It's actually a true story. When I was born, I was dropped in a box of glitter, and I've been shining ever since. So, y'all can go ahead and hate if you want to. I'm gonna be alright.
Definitely be seeing you from space tonight.
I sure hope so. I'm probably radiate a whole lot of energy and fuck up people's telemoon bill tonight.
And I'm gonna contour the nose just a little bit.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if that'll be sun matched. Yes. Perfect.
Keep blending.
Like Wendy Williams. She looks like a letter B. She kind of does. It's strange. But always the snatch, though. It's snatched. All these notifications. Y'all people leave me alone. Busy.
We'll be putting on lashes.
Keep these lashes, y'all. Yes. Okay. And the lashes usually complete the look for a lot of people, but
we still need lips.
Yeah. Exactly.
Do those last.
One thing missing. The whole troublemaker. That's actually actually a really pretty color right there. And it matches already. It matches everything we just did.
Exactly. Any nude color goes with any look.
Anything.
Now, when you do take your lashes out of the package, you do want to take both ends and kind of bend them so then they do become flexible for the wearer. And I did not put any glue on them yet because I will be measuring them to my client's eye at the moment. And I'm just going to have you look down. Don't entirely close your eye. And I'm going to lift your eye. I'll just place it right on top. See if it's long enough. Or if it's too long. It's a little bit long, but I'm going to cut the outer edges. I'm gonna have you look down, not entirely close your eyes. Close your eye because it's dry. Yes, I do put my glue right here on my wrist.
Storm is over.
That's not like my icy cold.
Have you looked down? And lip.
I'm surprised you just put the liner on first.
I didn't realize we were doing liner.
Oh.
I don't think we need it.
Yeah, I didn't think so either after I...
Liner makes your eyes look smaller. You want your eyes to look bigger. You want them to pop. So, no liner today. Just lashes. Go ahead and flutter your eyes a bit. Make sure you're comfortable.
Okay, well, first of all... let's get this... not
on your eye, yeah. Told you to keep your eyes open. Let me see, turn towards me. You gotta let it dry first and then it'll. But right now, I'm just gonna have you push your eyelashes up. I'm just gonna hold them up a little bit. Alright, now look at me. And get that glue off. Look up. Look up. Good thing about this glue, comes off very, very easily. I'm gonna go back over with their.
I was thinking maybe tweezers.
A shadow. Come here, look up. There we go.
Alright. Okay.
And now for the lips. Gotta get used to having lashes on for a little bit.
Okay. I am a huge fan, I don't know if you could tell or not, but I am a huge fan of the Kar Jenner clan.
Really?
So, the lip is not by KKW Beauty, sadly, but it is from, you know, self-made billionaire Kylie Jenner. So this is the Kylie Jenner Velvet Liquid Lipstick that comes in the Kris Jenner cosmetic pack. So when you buy this, it comes with this and it comes with the shadows. And this was, you know, well worth as much as it cost, you know, it was up there. But I will be telling you, because this is the first time I have ever used anything from Kylie Jenner's lip kit. Usually it's just the face makeup that I use, not her lipsticks, because I feel like they were hyped up more than they should have been. So this is going to be my full and honest review of a piece of a Kylie lip kit. So, better not disappoint me, because I'm huge fans of that. I mean, like, huge. Even though I'm trying to, you know, replace Kim Kardashian, but it's okay.
Alright, so now you turn towards me and open your lip just a little bit. A little bit more so I can get that inner corner. There you go. smells amazing, though.
Yeah, but it's extra. It's a lot more pigmented than I thought it would be.
Once it dries, it's not as pigmented. Everything always changes colors once it dries.
Let's hope so.
What was this called again?
Velvet.
This is just a type. What was the name of the...
Oh.
Todd Cranes.
Todd Cranes, yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely a lot brighter than...
Then it seems you might have to go over there with a gloss or something to mute it.
Most definitely. I will do that now.
Yeah, I was going to say, because it's, woo!
It's hot.
Yeah.
Very hot.
I look like that singing frog from Princess and the Frog.
I'm gonna have you blot. What are you doing? You just wiped away a whole corner of your... Oh, excuse me.
Ooh! Yeah, I was gonna say.
Yeah, no, definitely have you blot your lips. We're gonna just go over with a nice red instead. What did you break?
We got a maybe a darker color.
Mixing.
Yeah. That was a fail, guys. That was a fail. I mean, the color that my lips are now looks better than what that was. Because that... Yeah, never again. I usually try things about one time, and if I'm feeling like that, after having purchased a $50 product, and that just so happened to come in the box, I would never buy it as a standalone product, more than likely. Because if that's how it looks, I'm not interested. But I'm pretty sure that's why they call it a lip kit, because it's that and like a gloss or something that goes over top of it and the liner and all of that to make it look a little better, because that was gross.
Go for more of a chocolatey red. Does it taste like chocolate? Might smell like it, may not taste like it.
I mean, I would love to taste it.
No, it's not. I'm looking up all the way. You can very lightly press your lips together, and then I'll have you blot, because it is a very thick lip gloss.
Because that's, you know, yeah, crisis averted. Shitless.
Just kiss it. Kiss again.
Okay.
what is the final step?
The final step. Okay, so this is
Essence
Matte Makeup Setting Spray.
Instant Matte?
Instant Matte is what it's called. And again, you can find it, I think it's your local beauty store, I'm pretty sure.
Usually Ulta has them. Yeah, not Essence isn't everywhere.
Yeah, Ulta or any name brand store of importance. So maybe Sephora, stuff like that.
Cool, done with that.
Okay.
It happens the same thing to me. As soon as I open up my mouth and I smile, it gets all over my teeth.
I see why the Kardashians eat like. I see it now. I used to think they were retarded. Ah! Okay. I'm not gonna open up my mouth very wide to do more.
And you just
oh my god. Okay.
This is why you do the trick. And it's all the way in the back teeth here too. Huh? Right in the gums.
Oh, fuck it. At this point, I don't care. Okay, yeah, I don't care. It just needs to hurry up and dry. But, all right. So, my last, actually, put myself back together. Oop. It's all right. It's fine because you won't see it. Anyways. All right. So, while I put myself back together, my Judy here will go get me my final step. To pull all this together. As soon as she's done doing whatever she's doing.
Any of the makeup off my hands?
Please don't get any of that. You know, on my baby. Thank you. Okay, I don't know what's going on with this button. But it just don't want a button. Alright, come on, come on. Okay.
Smells like hairspray.
Yeah, because there's a lot of it.
There's so much lipstick on your teeth right now.
Oh my god.
So I could do the trick that I told you.
Let's hope it worked. Let's hope it worked. Because I'm tired of seeing stuff on my teeth. Okay.
Go ahead.
So.
I'll start picking up.
My baby. Just remove it from the head. Bring it forward, bring it forward, bring it forward. Thank you. clearly I've done my own hair because I don't trust other people to do.
Except for me.
Yeah, except for her. She's the only person that I can really say
will look out her.
For my best interest.
We'll be doing your natural hair next week as well.
Yes, we do several hair appointments, and as you can see, I am a huge fan of big hair. As Dolly Parton would say, the higher the hair, the closer to God. Or the bigger the hair, the harder they stare. So, I live by those mottos, and I feel like it really, again, with the lipstick, has done me great justice. Let me open this up a little bit wider. Alrighty. So that pretty much concludes it. So when I'm gonna put all the products that we used today in the description down below, and I'm going to put my makeup artist's information down there in the description below for people who live in South Florida or Miami Beach or wherever. All of that information will be accessible to you, and stay perfectly imperfect, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.